Esta. Nu? What's happening? You aren't sleeping?
I wanted to attend to your dad before coming. I want us to finish the discussion.
What discussion?
The one we started in the kitchen.
Oh.
So what's your question?
Okay. The question is it bad for me to have a boyfriend at this age, or am I still young to have a boyfriend?
But you have one.
No. Mom, I don't.
What about those boys in your group, especially the ones in the church? Are they your enemies? Are they not your friends?
Mom, what you know what I mean? You know the kind of friends I'm talking about? You and dad were friends before you married. That's the kind of friends I'm talking about.
I understand you perfectly. It is not bad. But are you ready to marry them? You are 15 years old. I'm an SS2. I'm going to marry in the next 2 or 3 years time.
No, Mom. You got married at the age of 24. I'll also love to get married at that age.
But you don't need that kind of friendship now.
But, Mom, Rita said they allowed them to start early in America. Even as early as 5 years.
Who do you want to be? Man or God?
God, of course.
In that case, let's see what God has to say about it. Open your Bible to Song of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 5.
I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, by the gazelles or by the doors of the field, do not stir up nor awaken love until it pleases.
Do you understand it?
That I should wait until I am ready or matured enough to undo it.
And do you know why?
Explain it, Mom.
This is because love between a man and a woman is very strong and very good when it is properly placed and given at the right time. But it can be disastrous and very frustrating when it is wrongly placed and released at the wrong time. It is given by God to men and women to enjoy, but you need to be patient to receive the full blessing.
But, why is it that sometimes we usually have this feelings or urge for such things, even when we know that it's not it? How can one handle such moments?
It is not totally wrong to have such feelings. It's a sign that your body is maturing, but it is your own responsibility to bring it under control. And this is done by the word of God and self-discipline. Any other solution apart from this can lead to frustration and disgrace. You need to constantly renew your mind in the word of God and prayers, and by keeping the right company.
Wow. Thank you, Mom.
Know you are spiritually strong. Be able to resist every lustful work that witches work against your soul. And be able to overcome temptations. Come, let me pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for my daughter.